Welcome back! So, I gotta admit, I feel like I need to step into the confession booth here, because I've got a confession to make, guys. I kinda peeked a little bit, just a little bit, at the strategy guide for this game. Not to find a solution for a puzzle or anything, but just to clarify where we've been this whole time and what's been going on as far as the challenges are concerned. It turns out that my theory about the whole, stage one being completed when you cross the bridge thing was actually correct. That will always happen no matter what, so that is good to know. There is no way you can be the first team to win that whole challenge. As for this, I accidentally found out that you can get the bag not at the sheep area, but over at the auction house. Yeah, I totally didn't even think of this. And this sort of thing happened in the Silent Spy as well, though more so off-screen.
Need to earn more points first. I can't go below 50.
Unfortunately, because of the rule book, we can't go below 50 whenever we make a purchase. I guess so that we won't jeopardize ourselves too much, you know, and get ourselves eliminated or something like that. So, I guess this is where we need to play the games here inside the Puzzle Palace. So I'm going to try this monster thing. Let's just see what the rules are. So we have to play as a monster, and the opponent is a farmer, and then we trade the roles. The winner is the player with the most cows remaining from their round is the farmer. Okay. I'm just going to try the easy one. Okay. Let's see, so we need to choose our three monsters. Oh, that's right, you have to make the cow a monster. Yeah, that's right, I remember this. We'll do that. Okay, done. And now we choose a cow to kill. Oh, their eyes got big! Let's see, move scared cows / monsters. Oh, this is where we shuffle them around. Okay, gotcha. Wait, I can't move the monsters? Okay, I'm kind of confused. I totally forgot how this works, guys. Like, how many turns do you get? Did I just kind of cook this? How do I can jump? Oh, okay, I guess that's how you do it. Okay. I didn't know you could jump. That's cool. I guess we can just move them all over here. Yeah, this is kind of confusing. I'm not sure what's going on. Okay, choose cow to kill. I can't even... Oh, here we go. Oh, this is where the adjacent stuff comes into play. Okay, gotcha. Okay, so we want to move them back that way. That's what we're looking at. So these are the two cows. These are the ones that are scared. Okay, I see how it works now. Are there any others? Oh, I see, okay. Bam. Okay. So there's no more... I guess the farther away they are, the less scared they're gonna be. Let's move the monsters closer to the... Oh, there we go. Oh, they killed our Okay. Oh, so the opponent gets to guess who the killer is, but they may be killing their own stuff. Oh, wow, we're actually doing pretty well. Wow, they went through all the cows. At least... I love all those cow sounds. At least it seems like they did. Okay, so move my cows. I guess I'll move one there and another one there. I don't know if it's a good idea to have them together. I kind of want to make some space. Yeah, why not? Guess the hidden monster. I bet, let's see, proximity-wise, you. Nope. Interesting. I bet it's this one. Nope. Is it this one? There's three here. We've got one of these has got to be it. And that one's always getting scared. Is it this one? Oh, really? Okay, this one hasn't gotten scared. Is it you? Aha! Let me try another one. We don't have many left, after all. Really? This one. Aww. Boo. Okay, I guess we lost. Yeah, I'm not a big fan of that game. Let's try Raid. I think that one's a little more luck-based, but, Whoa, we need to look at the rules. Let's see. We need to be the first player to enter the castle, moves their pawn. Okay, so these are... Whoa, okay. I'm kind of confused. So, the spiky-looking thing, that is a what? Okay, so I pick a card from on my hand to put back into the deck, and then follow the action of the color of the square. This game's confusing. I kind of like the idea of it, though. I just feel like it's way too involved. Well, that's a pretty nice card, so that's a balanced one. You know what? I think I'm going to go for that, return that one to the deck. So do I have to pick something? Oh, I have to challenge somebody, don't I? Well, what do I have? I'll challenge you. 9? Alright, I got that one. Sweet. Okay, I got another spike thing. So, does a heart deal you another card? Let me see that. Yeah, they gain a card, so that's cool. So I guess we're just gonna have to watch all the CPU players here. Alright, You know, at the end of The Captive Curse, I forgot what the guy's name was, but the guy who made this game, who was the character in that game, said that he was gonna make a new card based on Nancy or something. I forgot what that was, but I'm wondering if that's here. Okay, so I have to challenge somebody. I'll challenge you. You got less stuff. And my most powerful green is this one. Awesome! Alright. The Corn Cannoneer. That's actually a pretty awesome profession. Ooh, I got another card. We're actually not doing so badly with this game. This is pretty good. So I take it you can only have a maximum of 5, right? That makes sense. Okay. Oh, so you go back when you lose stuff. Okay. Yeah, my memory of this game is really fuzzy, guys. I don't really remember this very much, because it's been a long time since I've seen The Captive Curse. We can't let him get ahead of us. 2? Really? Oh, good, we can move ahead. Oh, yeah, white lets you go again, right? Isn't that what white is? Yeah, move forward to next white square. If player land on white square closes the castle, player remains on that square. Is that what we did? No, I guess you just move forward to the next one and then you wait again. Makes sense, I guess. So you really don't want to land on the spiky things. Is he challenging me, I guess? Whose turn is it? It's Yellow's turn, so Orange. This was my best one. Let's go for that. Bam! Awesome. Alright. Go back. Yeah, there you go. There you go. Cool. Okay. 5. Okay, that's not bad. So purple... What does purple do? Steal a card from any other player. Okay, nice. I'll take that one. Okay, and black is making a comeback. Except he landed on black square, which I think puts you back to the start. Or the black square, or previous black square, which I guess would put you close to the start, which would make you at start. Something like that. Yeah, I kind of like this game. This is cool. I mean, it's luck-based to a certain extent, but I like it. It's not so bad. And I say that right as I get a kind of a bad card, or bad space. See, that's nice for red and blue, but not elsewhere. This one, yeah, not a big fan of that card. I'll throw it away. So now I challenge somebody on green. I'll go for purple. Or I should have gone for yellow because they only have one. Ah. Oh. Why did I do that? Aw, man. I'm gonna lose. Oh, no! Maybe on easy difficulty, the computer makes really bad decisions or something. Wait, didn't I have to go back to the previous black? Huh. That was odd. You'd think that I would go back to the previous black. Is there a rule about that? No, there's not. Okay. Let's try again. Red. Okay. So, yeah, I'm going to pick you because you've got only one card. And this is definitely a surefire win. I mean, 15. I don't think there's anything higher than 15, right? Good. All right. So, we won. Awesome! So, do we get, like, a point value? Okay, I guess not. Well, let's go back outside to the auction house and see if we got any new points. Also, can we look at this? No, we can't. Okay. Still wondering when that will come into play, but I guess one day. Alright, we've now got 60. Okay, perfect. So you get 10 points per win, I guess. Alright, so now that we got a bag, we can totally go back out and do the wolf thing. And I promise you guys, I don't know any more than that. I didn't read any further. Once I saw that, I'm like, no, I gotta stop here. In fact, that point in the strategy guide was even before you did the machine here. So, I mean, there's stuff that I've done yet, that I've done already, that this guide hasn't even gotten to at this point. So, we need a bag for the wool, so let's go ahead and get our wool all bagged up. And let's put the bag in here.
Where's my medallion?
What?
Looks like someone got here first.
No! No! You've got to be kidding. What happened to our medallion?
Now on Pacific Run, New Zealand. They say it's a poor shepherd who blames his sheep. But even if not one contestant located a single sheep, congratulations, Team Kia. Remaining teams still have a chance to place their medallions for second place, except Teams Kakoa and Korea Ria, who have been shorn from the competition. Aww. And must now flock to the shameful shores of Loser Atoll.
Okay, so I guess that's it. All right, so we gotta find this medallion. We've done the wool thing.
Haven't done that.
Oh, I guess we technically haven't done that. Okay. Well, let's talk to Bess about what's happened. Actually, we need to look up what this team's color is. Let's look at our rulebook. So we've kind of got a red, a dark green, and a light blue. So who has that? Does anybody have that? I don't see anybody that has those colors. I mean, red and dark green seem to be the Kia colors, but light blue isn't exactly on there unless that's just part of some other background-ish type thing. Let's talk to Bess.
What's up?
I need your help distracting Patrick.
Got it.
Ooh, we can snoop around his stuff. Okay, great. Except Lena's here, but maybe she won't care.
Can't go in there now.
Okay, Patrick was sitting here. Does that mean we can just... This is what we could look at earlier, so... I guess that distraction thing only works when Lena is not here. Right? I mean, it makes sense.
I saw you in the out-of-bounds area.
Are you sure?
What's the game? What are you after?
Just visiting George.
That might be true. So I'll let it slide. For now. If you do me a favor.
What's that?
Ask Sunny if this means anything to him.
Oh, it's another comic! Let's see. The Beginner's Guide to Codebreaking, a guide for travelers and their dogs. But that great tree was struck by lightning right as it dawned on her. I've got it! Ah, who are you? What in the world? So that's like a guy in a cave and he gets hit by drops of water and he sinks? I don't get it.
See how he reacts. Don't tell him it came from me.
Okay. Lena, it seems like she's got an angle here. I mean, she and Patrick were arguing earlier about trying to find some dirt on Sunny, so I think we got something in common here. I mean, we can work with this.
Did you take our medallion?
Right. Section 2, middle paragraph. No player shall remove a medallion in the course of an active competition segment.
So that's a no?
Did you not read the rules?
I skimmed.
You want a free tip?
Is there such a thing?
Only when it doesn't matter. Here's how you win anything. Read the rules. Losers see rules as limitations. Winners see rules as a direct path to winning.
I'll keep that in mind.
$10 says you'll never read the rules.
Hey, we totally read the rules. Wait, she's gone. Oh. All right, snooping time.
What's up, my man?
Oh, hello.
That's a great rock. Am I right? I'm right.
Okay, nothing different there.
Anyway. I'd better figure out the combination first.
Okay, yeah. Wait a minute. Hang on. GDA. So 741? Maybe they correspond to letters. Let's see. Yes, they did. All right. Deduct 50. Ooh.
I think I need more information to crack this code.
Up, up, down, right. Wow, that's interesting. So we can just take this? I'm kind of surprised. Sunny only talks to a select group of contestants. Well, it can be removed or not removed. I bet Nancy will know sure enough. I don't want to spend too much time. Aaron MIA? Kiri's making a name for herself. You can get Patrick for water, but try to get him into it? Not going to happen. Huh. So these are his notes on the kayaks. Oh, so this is the guide to the direction-y thing. Oh. Wait, this is another... Jin's coded notes from Sunny. Spaceships. What is this? Oh, so much new stuff, guys. New stuff. Okay, good. We didn't get caught. Perfect. Okay, wow. How are we doing up here, by the way? We're in last. Oh, man. Oh, wow. Let's talk to George. Let's see if she's here.
You need to ask Sunny about the clues you've been finding.
Sure. Why?
Well, he keeps asking about my sleuth friend and what she's up to. It's like he's been getting impatient.
Why doesn't he ask us if he wants to talk to us or is so interested in us?
Has Sunny been visiting you?
Yes, Nancy. He wants me to help him build a machine.
Now that is interesting.
Or review blueprints. I guess it's confusing.
Keep working on it. Maybe it'll explain what he's up to.
Got it.
Well, if it makes you feel any better, everyone here is confusing.
I keep finding these comics.
I think Sunny wants you to read them.
You know, the comics are kind of an interesting explanation for why Sonny doodles so much. I guess he got it from his grandfather.
I'm still not making any progress with who cut the bridge.
That's really good. Sorry, I'm just a little sleepy.
Aww. Well, sleep well, Bess. Or Bess, George. What am I saying? Let's see, any new tablet stuff? No. Same old thing. Okay, any new stuff here? I think it's just the same old... Yeah. Okay, let's go out and see if we can talk to Sunny some more. Maybe talk to Kiri a little bit more. Yeah, let's see what we can do. I'm wondering, do we have to put all these back? I wonder if they're going to notice that they're gone. Well, this is a competition, so... Maybe they'll suspect that somebody was taking them in the first place. I don't know.
It's been fun, but I'm turning against you now.
Okay, why?
Yeah.
I am dissolving this partnership. You are no longer needed.
Thanks for the notice, I guess.
Do you mind if I play it a bit different for the camera?
Could not care less.
Excellent.
Just go easy on Bess.
Oh, sure thing.
Thanks. Well, it's been fun, I guess.
Fair warning. Things will be different next time we talk.
Got it.
Well, I can't honestly say that I'm surprised.
Bye-bye.
Later.
Okay, Sunny, what's going on here, buddy?
Hey, you.
I kind of want to be more discreet about this. I didn't want to say Lena was involved with this.
Lena wanted me to show you this comic.
Nancy!
Did you leave it for her to find?
Yeah.
Was it some sort of message?
Wouldn't that be cool? I've got something for you.
Ooh. Another one. Did I ever tell you about the charred tree and the woman who spoke without words? What are these comics talking about?
Do you like comics?
Do you?
I do. Very much. The good ones teach us so much about ourselves.
Tell me about Jin, your grandfather.
I didn't leave that name just lying around for you to trip on. You're reading my things.
Well, yeah.
Let's say I was.
Are we saying it together, or is this a competition to see who can say it better?
Can you focus?
Nope. You're just afraid I'll win.
Sunny, I read your grandfather's letter.
I know.
Can you talk to me about that?
I wanted you to read it.
Why?
I need your help.
With what?
But some things I might have to send you when you're not next to me.
Okay, we can ask him a lot of stuff here.
Are you leaving the comics for me to find?
I think the line between something existing and something waiting to be found is smudgy in your case.
Very true.
You're not the first to say that.
Other people say smudgy?
You know a lot about me, and everyone else here, it seems.
Yeah.
You're interesting.
Yeah, how does he know so much about us? I'm still thinking that this whole us being on the show is just a setup that he's orchestrated.
So you were pretty close to your grandfather?
Oh yeah, he's sort of my hero. But everyone else just seems embarrassed by him. A lot of the family won't use her last name.
Huh, that's extreme. Why would they do that?
Because he's different.
Well, I can kind of tell based on his letter.
What's the story with the machine you want George to build?
It's for my science fair.
That seems unlikely.
I wasn't prepared to lie. I don't do my best work under pressure.
Someone took our medallion.
I know.
Can you help me figure out what to do?
I could. I won't.
All right. Well, that's kind of disappointing.
Goodbye.
See ya.
All right. So we've pretty much exhausted all the conversations, except with Patrick, I suppose. So follow the clues in the waterfall comic. Let's see. That's the code notes. We got a lot of stuff here that we can look around at. Where are the comics? Here you go. Now, this was the original one with the... Oh, they're all together. Okay, great. So, this is a waterfall. I guess these are in order? Like, how does she know what order to put these in? Huh, okay. Well, we do know of a place with a waterfall. It's over by the, Mossburn area, where the bridge was. So let's go head over that way. In fact, I'm going to check on something. I'm wondering, is the medallion in one of these little boxes here, like the one here? No, it doesn't seem like it. What about this thing? Nothing. Okay. Just want to check. You never know. I'm just trying to look for things that don't have a use right now, but they could later on. Okay, waterfall, waterfall. There's another area here. We haven't seen this yet. Huh. That kind of looks like a...
This looks like the spot from the comet.
Yeah.
I should investigate.
What is this? Wow. Nice place.
Interesting. Looks like I could open this if I found the right key.
Okay, it looks like there's like a flying saucer and there's like a Dalek or something here. Another Dalek on the other side. Some kind of salt or pepper shaker where the keyhole is, and some little tripod things. Interesting. I mean, I gotta admit, all these alien drawings that Sunny has made kinda do seem a little kitschy. Where do we turn these scorecards in, I wonder? I need to look at the rulebook again. I guess you have to keep the rulebook in your tents or something. Okay, that just goes back there. So there's nothing else to look at here. I just want to make sure before we hightail it off. The only thing we can look at is this locky thing. And I guess... Does this do any good?
Hmm.
No. We already used the producer key, so that's not going to work. Deduct car. Ooh. So how do we use these cards? I need to go back to the field area and find out. Okay, so we follow the clues.
Still have to do that.
Or not. Okay. Interesting stuff. I'm intrigued. This alien stuff is... I don't know. It's interesting. So, at this point, I'm going to go back here for now. Also, I've been wondering what this circle, like, hexagon-y thing is. Like, I'm standing on it, but I can't see it when I'm standing on it. This thing. So, do I put my cards in somewhere? Let me go back and read the rules again. It's been a little while, so it's probably worth checking out, right? Also, have we gotten any further notifications? Yeah, we did. Stage 3 now unlocked. I kind of wish I knew what Stage 3 was. It's probably inside the underwater place, isn't it?
You know, you won't get away with bending the rules forever.
You talked to Sunny?
I did. He's, looking into it.
Well done. I'll toast your closing of a loophole with the opening of a new loophole.
Uh-oh.
That feels a lot like cheating to me.
Me too.
I'm sensing that this is your main strategy.
In part. I really do like a fair fight. But I also like winning. I'm just giving myself enough room to decide a path later. Do yourself a favor and read the rules.
I took your advice and read the rules.
Oh yeah? In the case of a direct tie, what are the 5 possible tiebreak activities?
In case of a tie, there's a sudden death round.
Good luck out there, Tiger.
I take it that wasn't the right answer.
How long have you and Patrick been together?
A while.
2 years, 4 months. Hey, no. 4 years. No.
Seems right.
How did you and Patrick get together?
Oh, I don't remember. He's more of the romantic one.
See, it's like, he doesn't even know anything about Patrick. That's what's making me suspicious about him.
What do you do when you're not on TV?
Lots of freelance work in the information sector.
What kind?
My resume is almost entirely acronyms at this point. I can't really disclose most of my work.
Oh, sounds intriguing.
Rarely, but on those rare days.
Do you believe in aliens?
Next question.
Is that a no?
If you have to ask, the answer is no.
What were you doing near the bridge before it collapsed?
I was looking for a fern like we were supposed to.
My friend almost died. If you had anything to do with it...
You'll what?
I don't know.
I didn't hurt your friend. Neither did Patrick.
You know, as much as she's a fierce competitor and everything, I do like her. I can respect that.
Want to hear a joke?
Sure.
This zebra's standing in a pack. A herd? Pride? Collective.
Herd is okay with me.
Okay, the zebra's standing in a pack. A group. It's all zebras, that's important.
I'm there.
And one zebra says, I'm hiding in plain sight. And this other zebra goes, oh no, that's my plan too.
That's pretty good.
Thanks.
I don't get it.
Good. I thought that was just me.
See, he's telling us all these jokes and stuff. I don't get it, though. What's going on?
Why did you tell me that zebra joke?
Was just thinking about it. How we all just do the same thing. But don't know we do the same thing because we don't really know what we're doing.
I guess you could say that.
It's a profound thought. Can you write it down?
Okay.
You always say that, Patrick.
Do you believe in aliens?
Why not?
Is this the first time you've thought about it?
Well, I've seen aliens, but believing in aliens seems more involved.
Whoa.
You've seen aliens?
Yeah.
Well, just a little.
I want to know more about that. Nancy, come on, ask him more about that.
Goodbye.
Nice talking to you.
Oh my goodness, seriously. Okay, so underwater challenge. This must be stage 3, and we must have to go back to the observatory. So I bet now we can use the submersible. Okay, well, we can look at the rules here. Now I kind of want to look at that tiebreaker thing. Except I don't even see... Yeah, I guess if you can earn a maximum of that many points, then... Well, there could be a tiebreaker. I don't know. So... How do we use these cards? Like, seriously, how do we do that? Redeem bonus cards at the scoreboard. Oh, the scoreboard! Oh, okay, right here. Gotcha. Okay, so do we just... Bam! Okay, there. Boom. Sweet. Okay, deduct points. You know... I don't want to deduct points from Lena and Patrick, because they're pretty far ahead, and that would just not do much for us, so... Tell you what, let's go after the team that's right next to us, right above us. Cocoa. There we go. Okay. That's a cool mechanic. I like that. So I guess we're going to have to be on the lookout for more stuff.
I think it's time for me to prove myself.
How so?
Whatever the next challenge is, I'm going to master it.
You sure?
Positive.
Great, then come out with us. Seriously, we've been doing everything this whole time. Okay, I'm gonna go back out to the underwater area and see what's up. Because, yeah, I'm not sure what to do about the medallion. Unless it's somewhere in the puzzle place. I mean, I haven't been in here yet. At least, I don't think I've been in here since we got the third challenge. And I still can't look at the Rubik's Cube.
Your light.
Ooh.
Do you have it? That's not good enough. Just give it to me.
Uh-oh.
Do not get caught. Yeah, you too.
Who's she talking to? And what's this? Best sent us a message. This just in. I already give up. Sorry. Well, that's no different than where we were a minute ago, Bess, so I can't really say that, that did much. I mean, I like you and everything, Bess, but we really need some help. Can we talk to Kiri about what we just heard?
Who do you think you are?
What?
I know who I am. I am Queen Kiri, and this is my court. You best stroll on out, lest you want to roll on out.
Whoa. I just need you to tell me something.
What did you just say to me? I think you better say it again, because it sounded like you just said you need me to tell you something.
Yeah.
This is my house, this is my country, and I'm going to win. Kiri.
So, what's your deal? I can't tell where you really stand.
I could say the same thing for you.
Could you?
Save it for the confessional, kid.
Yeah, she's putting on a show.
Hey, you.
Bye-bye.
Cool.
Okay, let's go back out there to the, place. I don't mean to sound mean-spirited toward Bess, it's just... I wish she and I got to do more stuff here. I mean, it just feels like she's just staying back at the camp and we're doing all the work. Okay. So what do we do under here? Do we have... Ooh, we do have a submersible.
It's about time I got to pilot a sub.
Awesome. Let's just make sure we got the stuff right. Well, this we do have to be by ourselves anyway. Let's see. Respect the marine life. Stay within the boundaries. To control the depth. Okay. Let's do this. Ooh, this looks cool. Okay. Well, tell you what, everybody, we will pilot the sub in the next video.